Уважаемые коллеги, добрый день.
Good afternoon, dear colleagues. I will speak about clinical oncology because I am a clinician, and I will also discuss the experiment shortly. The theme of my presentation are metformin and melatonin and complex therapy of breast cancer. When melatonin was not discovered as a substance, there were observations that the patients at autopsy at such morphological alterations are hypertrophy of BCCs, development of multiple cysts, calcification, and in patients with breast cancer who died of their disease. And in the mid-20th century, it was shown that among all the patients who have malignant tumors, in patients with hormone-positive mammary gland cancer, there was there were low night peak concentrations of melatonin. It was compared with healthy volunteers under randomized study. As we might speak a lot about melanin, and I will try to explain it. This is meta-analysis of 2018. It includes a lot of studies concerning the use of melatonin in clinical practice in monotherapy and in combination with different types of medical treatment, interleukins, interferons, hormone therapy, and chemotherapy. And if we look at it in general, there are striking results. Melatonin increasing total survivability, frequency of objective responses to treatment. I analyzed it in detail, and I analyzed each of the studies separately. So what can be said here first? Only one author was dealing with it. Secondly, practically in no study there is a subgroup analysis. They include the patients with different tumors, with different localizations of metastasis, with different peacock status, and not only with solid tumors, but also with lymphoproliferative diseases, and then the conclusion was drawn concerning the general group. However, if we look at the context of the breast cancer, it is difficult to find such analysis as to how melatonin affects the course of the disease against the background of its administration in combination with different cytostatics and hormone therapy. Very high doses. It was mentioned 1 milligram per day, and here the doses are from 1 to 40 milligrams per day that exceeds 20 or 30 fold standard dose of melatonin. We can praise it, but we shouldn't overpraise, and it is a pity that all the studies were mainly conducted 10 or 15 years ago, and after a great number of the papers were published, and now we have multiple meta-analyses only of the publications that were done at that time, and they have several drawbacks concerning planning of the clinical trials. As for metformin, we have already said that we had cohort studies, for instance, Danish study, which is well known. They showed that mainly the patients with diabetes mellitus who take metformin have a lower risk of getting breast cancer, for instance. The studies looked further and the design, which study shown in the table was based on retrospective analysis of a certain base of patients, commonly that is one major oncological center, and the patients who were treated because of breast cancer, the stages were localized, and part of the patients had concomitant pathology, diabetes mellitus, and part of that group took metformin. So only in two of six studies it was recorded that administration of metformin can increase total non-relapse-free survivability that is of interest in case of positive tumors. That is an example of one of the studies with the greatest median of observation, more than 100 months. And in the diagram, it was shown that administration metformin increases total survival rate. We compare with a group of the patients who didn't take metformin but who had diabetes mellitus. And non-recurrence survival is also increased, but these differences are close to statistically significant. The researchers wanted to know why they were close to statistically significant. Group analysis shows that due to a group of patients that with three positive type of breast cancer, there is a dramatic divergence of the curves. In this group, non-relapse-free survival is higher when they get metformin. The evidence base are prospective clinical studies mainly, and that is not a complete list, but some of the studies have been finalized, some of them are underway so far, and some of them have already been published. Arrow shows the studies that were conducted at the Institute of Oncology named after Petrov. I will discuss them later. Now I will show the results of two other studies from the table that have already been published. One of them is design is quite simple. Non-adjuvant hormone therapy with letrozole. The patients also took metformin or placebo. That was a randomized study. But if we look at the data, they are quite contradictory. We didn't have any increase in the group of taking metformin or frequency of objective response. So there were no increase of the frequency of organ preservation surgery. Some patients were subject to intermediate biopsy after 4 weeks of treatment, not all of them. And they assessed the surrogate marker of relapse-free survival as Ki-67. In patients who took metformin in combination with hormone therapy, the index K67 is less than 10%. It was higher than in the group that received standard treatment. However, these data were not confirmed when the surgical treatment was given. Commonly, that is in 4 months after the onset of non-adjuvant hormone therapy. The second study, metastatic patients also took metformin in combination with the aromatase inhibitors. There was anastrozole and letrozole. There no difference was between the groups in terms of survivability without progression or total survival rate. But the design leaves much to be desired because the patients were included at different lines of therapy. Some of them received the second line, some on the third, the fourth, or the fifth line. And the groups were not homogeneous. Another study. Retrospective analysis of treated patients from 1999 to 2010, radical treatment in terms of breast cancer, and they analyzed their achievements of complete pathomorphosis in the patient. That was in Anderson in the USA by the group of pathologists from the same center that increases the specificity in general of the results. It was determined that among the patients who suffered from diabetes mellitus, in addition to breast cancer, there was a complete pathomorphosis, statistically more significant than in patients who suffered from diabetes mellitus but didn't get metformin. At the Oncology Institute, we also conducted a study targeted at improving the results of treatment of patients with locally advanced breast cancer by using melatonin and metformin. The task of the studies, I won't detailize them, there was an experimental part and a clinical part. In the experimental part, we tested melatonin and metformin in combination with cytostatic and hormone therapy in terms of reticulated tumors of mammary gland in mice. In the clinical part, we under randomized prospective study, we study how melatonin and metformin can affect the results of the treatment. Briefly about the experiments. The design of the experiments was similar to mice of a certain line. The strain of the tumor was inoculated. In that case, that was ERK solid tumor. Then they were randomized under 6 groups of treatment. In this experiment, it was shown that melatonin potentiates the effects of antitumoral doxorubicin to lower curves. Unlike monotherapy with doxorubicin, there was a potentiation of the action of cytostatic melatonin. In the second experiment with a similar design with another tumor, HER2-positive tumor of breast cancer, there was a potentiating action of cytostatic to melatonin metformin. So melatonin monoregime didn't show its efficacy, whereas melatonin monoregime was similar in efficacy with a cytostatic pancreatic cell. In the third experiment, it was shown that there was potentiation of effect of antitumoral antiestrogen, terimifin, with the addition of metformin to treatment on model of the same tumor. Clinical part, two arms, patients with all biological subtypes of breast cancer, prior to neoadjuvant chemotherapy, they were studied. They randomized under three groups. First, standard anthracycline with a scheme of chemotherapy. The second group, the same with melatonin. The third, the same with metformin. It lasted for six courses. Then there was a surgery to all the patients, and primary endpoint was the achievement of total pathomorphosis. The secondary endpoint, subjective response, and the quality of life of the patient. The groups of patients were rather homogeneous in terms of all indicators. So as a result of multifactorial analysis, it was revealed that neither melatonin nor metformin affect the achievement of total pathomorphological response, whereas this indicator was statistically high in patients with HER2-positive tumor of breast cancer that is confirmed by published evidence. But we got interesting data on life quality, namely, we revealed that by questioning prior, during, and after chemotherapy in the group of patients who received chemotherapy with melatonin, of course, the life quality not only improved, it didn't deteriorate unlike other groups based on three indicators. They had better sleeping, they had less fatigue, and their real functioning improved. And the second arm are the patients with luminal AB subtypes. They received on adjuvant regime hormotherapy with trimifen in mono regime in combination with melatonin and metformin. That therapy lasted 4 months, and then there was surgery, and the primary endpoint was achievement of the decrease of K67 index against therapy, and the secondary endpoints was objective response and quality of life of the patients. This is just a group of patients and their characteristic. So as a result of multifactorial analysis, melatonin administration had an effect on objective response that showed up in statistically important increase in frequency of objective response in that group of patients. That affected the frequency of reducing the index of K67 against therapy that was statistically significant. I'm just showing that there was a more objective effect based on instrumental studies after therapy in the group on non-adjuvant hormotherapy with melatonin. And here, books put median index of K67 prior to treatment in group of terimifen and metformin. It was 20% before and 9% after. That was statistically significant. An interesting observation was a correlation of body weight index with reducing K67 index in patients with estrogen-positive breast cancer in one group, in the group of neoadjuvant hormotherapy with metformin. So the higher the body weight index, the higher would the chance to decrease the index K67. As the difference in life, there was no difference. It didn't deteriorate or improve. And generally, we not only we are dealing with that problem, but there is a whole team of people that was initiated by the Belgian scientists, and they are supported by the scientists from many other countries who are dealing with collecting data about drugs that have been registered for some other treatment. for treatment of any other condition, non-oncological diseases. And now there are 237 drugs, among them metformin and melatonin. In the table, you can see the most prospective drugs, which have the highest evidence base that they can be once used in clinical oncology as a combinatory agent with standard treatment. But of course, much remains to be done. We have to collect data. Thank you very much for your attention. Questions? Are there questions? It is indicated to take. Do you think it is
indicated? The effect of metformin and melatonin on cancer patients is related to the age of the patient or not?
Yes.
No. No, as to the results of our studies, we included that indicator into our multi-factor analysis. There were no differences. There was no difference in efficacy of the treatment. It did not correlate to age. That was in our study only. Very few.
Thanks for the answer. But I would like to ask if, because age can be from, say, 55, 60, the patients, to 85, 90. And within this period, the aging is much different in people of 50, 60 with cancer, or in people of age 80 or 85. So even in the oldest old, there is no difference in the effect of metformin and melatonin in treated people.
In all the groups, we studied that, but age did not correlate. Younger and older patients didn't correlate with this. So there was no difference in efficacy of them, even in the oldest patients. Very last question. I'm sorry, microphone is not used.
В смысле, развивается в каком плане?
Can you repeat the question?
Сколько лет развивается?
Скажите, пожалуйста.
I have a question. Well, as to breast cancer, what was the standard statistical value? It's not 1 year what it's all developing. How long did it take to develop breast cancer in this or that patient? It depends. It's very different. Depends on the type and so on. Let's say some median amount of time when the breast cancer is developing in the country, of course, in the woman across the country. I don't have this information. Let's say it's prophylaxis of breast cancer. It depends. You should take into account lots of different factors. It's very individualized. I did speak about prophylaxis. I was talking about treatment, of course, treatment. But actually, you can retard the tumor development for a year or something. The process of development of breast cancer is long. It does take 1 month, let's say, or maybe even years. And did you take that into consideration as the time for development of tumor in breast cancer? Let's say, how did into account the time framework. We didn't take time into account because treatment efficacy is not assessed like that. We do not assess this time Neither study is saying that we should assess efficacy of drug on the time when each or this or that patient develops cancer. So you did go this individually? No, we didn't. Thank you very much.